this consideration of offenses is very, very important. Here is an important statement from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna naam kore aparadhir vichar. Krishna bolile aparadhir na hoy vikar. There are offenses to be considered while chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. Therefore, simply by chanting Hare Krishna, one does not become ecstatic. The holy name of Lord Krishna takes into consideration the performance of offenses. We might be committing offenses any time during the chanting or outside of the chanting period, but Krishna considers these. If one chants Krishna's name, the offenders do not transform themselves fully. In other words, they don't become ecstatic. It is very beneficial to chant the name Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda before chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, because by chanting these two holy names, Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, one immediately becomes ecstatic, and if he then chants the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, he becomes free of offenses. There are 10 offenses to avoid in chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. The first offense is to blaspheme great personalities who are engaged in distributing the holy name of the Lord. It is said in the Shastra, Krishna Shakti Vinana He Tar Pravartan. One cannot distribute the holy names of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra unless he is empowered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, one should not criticize or blaspheme a devotee who is thus engaged. This is a very serious offense. Shri Padma Purana states, Satam Ninda Namna Paramam Paradam Vitanute Yatah Khyatim Yatam Kathamu Sahate Tad Vigarham. To blaspheme the great saintly persons who are engaged in preaching the glories of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is the worst offense at the lotus feet of the holy name. One should not criticize a preacher of the glories of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. If one does so, he is an offender. The Nama Prabhu, who is identical with Krishna, will never tolerate such blasphemous activities, even from one who passes as a great devotee. So the idea is, even if I claim to be a great devotee, or I have my admirers who imagine that I am a great devotee, if I commit such blasphemous activities as under-respecting or disrespecting Vaishnavas, specifically those who distribute the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra out of aggressive compassion, then the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, who is also known as the Nama Prabhu, the Lord in the form of the holy name, he will become greatly irritated and offended, and he will withdraw his compassion, or at least suspend his active compassion. The second Nama Parad is described as follows. Shivasya Shri Vishnur Ya Iha Guna Nama Adi Sakalam Dhyā Bhinnam Pashye Sa Khalu Harinama Hitakara. In this material world, the holy name of Vishnu is all auspicious. Vishnu's name, form, qualities and pastimes are all transcendental, absolute knowledge. Therefore, if one tries to separate the absolute personality of Godhead from his holy name or his transcendental form, qualities and pastimes, thinking them to be material, that is offensive. Similarly, to think that the names of demigods such as Lord Shiva are as good as the name of Lord Vishnu, or in other words, to think that Lord Shiva and the other demigods are other forms of God and are therefore equal to Vishnu is also blasphemous. This is the second offense at the lotus feet of the holy name of the Lord. This is also a very serious offense. We cannot become Hindus. The third offense at the lotus feet of the holy name, which is called Gurur Avagya, is to consider the spiritual master to be material and therefore to envy his exalted position. A spiritual master who is repeating the instructions of the liberated acharyas in the disciplic line has to be awarded appropriate respect in order to receive mercy from Lord Krishna. We cannot criticize one who is delivering us Krishna's own instructions coming through the disciplic line. Krishna is very sensitive to this. The fourth offense, Shruti Shastra Nindanam, is to blaspheme Vedic literature such as the four Vedas and the Puranas. We should not criticize the four Vedas, nor should we criticize the Puranas. They are all meant for elevating people at different stages of consciousness, and we should not criticize them for any reason. Even out of a great so-called devotional ecstasy, we should not criticize scriptures, which may adopt various gradual methods to uplift people who are stuck up within the three modes of material nature. The fifth offense, Arthavada, is to consider the glories of the holy name to be exaggerations. We should not imagine that the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra has been excessively glorified in the scriptures in order to incite us to chant it so that we can come to the mode of goodness and so on. It is very wrong to consider that statements which factually describe the potency of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra to be pious advertisement texts, Arthavada texts. Similarly, the sixth offense, Harinamni Kalpanam, is to consider the holy name of the Lord to be imaginary. The seventh offense is described as follows. Namno balad yasihi papa buddhi na vidyate tasya yamairhi shuddhi. To think that since the Hare Krishna mantra can counteract all sinful reactions, one may therefore go on with the sinful activities and at the same time chant the Hare Krishna mantra to neutralize them is the greatest offense at the lotus feet of Harinam. Srila Prabhupada used to get extremely irritated when he remembered or saw a devotee is committing this offense. The Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is very kind, and therefore we should do whatever is required to stay away from sinful activities or offenses. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur has explained that in pure devotional service, the first condition is we cannot engage in sinful activities. And he drew our attention to this famous shloka which defines pure devotional service, stated by Srila Rupa Goswami, Anyabhilashita Shunyam Gyanakarma Dhyanavrutam Anukulyana Krishnanu Shilanam Bhaktaruttama. And he pointed out that Anyabhilashita, the state of constantly hankering for other things, primarily refers to sinful activities and offenses. So that has to be out. We cannot imagine that while we chant Krishna's names, we can parallelly go on with this. No, it is my duty to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, to engage in other forms of devotional service in such a manner that first of all, I am out of sinful activities. Okay, let's have a quick look at this table, which I often use in my teaching. Here you find Anya Abhilashita, and following Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati's explanation, who routinely explained that this refers to sinful activities and offenses. I have put this as the lowest column here. Sinful activities means activities which are against the teachings of the Vedas. In other words, it is adharma. Look at this. This is Srimad Bhagavatam. Veda pranihito dharmo hi adharmas tad viparyaya vedo narayana sakshat swayambhur iti shushruma. That which is prescribed in the Vedas constitutes dharma, the religious principles, and the opposite of that is irreligion. The Vedas are directly the supreme personality of God in Narayana and are self-born. This we have heard from Yamaraj. So, sinful activities are activities which are against the Vedas, and everything superior to that, anything else that I have put on top of this, these are all within the Vedic teachings. And the Vedas, according to Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, present four levels of information. Karma, which leads to enhanced sense enjoyment, and actually purification of heart. Srila Baladeva Vidyabhushan points out that Varna Dharma and Ashrama Dharma, which constitute karma, they are actually designed by the Lord to provide reduction of lust, anger and greed. So it actually leads to Hrid Vishuddhi, purification of heart. Then Jnana is a means of meditating on the impersonal Brahman, but it contains several different subdivisions there. Yoga is a means of meditating on the Paramatma feature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And of course, Bhakti is actually a means to meditate on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan. We have 64 different ways of meditating on the Supreme Lord, which have been neatly categorized in 9 different divisions: Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atmani, Vedanam. Now, outside of Bhakti and outside of sinful activities too, you have this Karma, Jnana, Yoga, these three. And generally, we simply refer to these three as material Dharma, and Bhakti, we refer to it as Bhagavata Dharma or spiritual Dharma. Now, material Dharma, when it is required for the execution of devotional service, then that is called Bhakti Anukul, favorable for Bhakti. And when it is not required for my practice of Bhakti, then it is called bhakti pratikul, unfavorable for bhakti. And within bhakti itself, the highest element of bhakti is to chant the holy names of Krishna. This has been stated by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very distinctly. For instance, here we find Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying, Navavidha bhakti purna nam hoite hoy. One can complete the 9 processes of devotion service simply by chanting the holy name. And here's another statement. Bhakti sadhan shreshta shunite hoilo man. Prabhu upadesh koilo namasankirtan. Then the Bhattacharya, Sarvam Bhattacharya, asked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which item is most important in the execution of devotion service? That Lord replied that the most important item was the chanting of the holy name of the Lord. So out of the 9 items, the most important item is the chanting of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And he quoted, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Iva Kevalam, Kalau Nasyeva, 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 Gatiranyatha. This is the basis for Lord Chaitanya's assertion. In this age of quarrel and hypocrisy, the only means of deliverance is the chanting of the holy names of the Lord. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. So, the idea is that the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is, chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is the highest aspect of Bhakti Yoga. But then, just immediately below that, you have Kirtana. Out of the 9 types of devotional activities, Kirtana itself has a special potency. This is a point that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur had also repeatedly underscored. Srila Prabhupada says, Srila Jiva Goswami states in his book Bhakti Sandarbha, Yadyapya Anya Bhakti Kalau Kartavya Tada Krishna Kirtanakhya Bhakti Sam Yoge Naiva. Out of the 9 processes of devotion service, Kirtan is very important. Srila Jiva Goswami therefore instructs that the other processes such as Archana Vandana, Dasya and Sakya should be executed, but they must be preceded and followed by Kirtana, the chanting of the holy name. There are different forms of Kirtana. There's Nama Kirtana, Rupa Kirtana, Guna Kirtana, Leela Kirtana. For instance, if you simply speak on the Srimad Bhagavatam, that is considered Guna Kirtana, talking about the qualities of the Supreme Lord, talking about Him. So those aspects of Kirtana, they are next to Nama Kirtana. This has been well enumerated by Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur also. And then below that you have the other aspects of bhakti. So anyway, this is to give a stratification in terms of potency, manifestation of potency. Krishna manifests most potency when we chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Potency of compassion, we are talking of, is Kripa Shakti. So, as I usually explain, we may be doing all of these activities, including sinful activities or offenses. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given a certain particular version of Krishna consciousness, which he greatly promoted for householders specifically, and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur applied it for the renunciants also, and others too, that even though we may engage in various forms of bhakti yoga, we are meant to increase the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra over time. We are supposed to increase it. So in this process, consider each column to be a step. Step 0 is when we are doing everything. Then step 1 would be when we start to increase the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. But we are supposed to reach step 2 to ensure that we don't commit sinful activities and offenses. Offenses are great sinful activities, but first of all, we should at least follow the 4 regulative principles. So it is our duty to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra without giving up our material and spiritual obligations in such a manner that we get out of sinful activities. This is an extremely important point. And we can go on increasing until we attain love of Godhead, which I have indicated in this red font. And there are further developments too. Nevertheless, we have to first of all get out of sinful activities. This is absolutely required if we need to progress in Krishna consciousness.